Hey y'all. Today I am making my mom a Christmas bag. Isn't this pretty? I just love this fabric with this gray faux leather. It is so pretty. So this will be our front panel, and here is our little slip pocket we're going to put on the front here. And then we will put our zipper pockets on this one. And here is the inside and the bottom. But here's our inside panels. And I am going to get this little slip pocket on here. And then we'll come back and do the zipper pocket. All right, guys. So I have. Here is our front panel. I put the name on here, and we have our D rings and our slip pockets right here. And this is the back panel. So we have our zipper. So now what we need to do is put this together, and then we will work on the inside. So right now, I need to make sure I mark our 2 inches on each side because that is going to go towards the sides. And this is our bottom. Which goes nicely right in there. I'm just trying to keep this from shifting. Okay, I'm going to go sew these two sides together about a quarter inch, and we will be right back. All right, so I got the bottom sewn on, and I went ahead and sewn the sides. I sewed both the sides down, so now we can do our corners, and then we can get started on the inside of the bag. Okay, I'm gonna go sew the corners down and we'll be right back and we'll look at it. All right, so I've got the corners sewn on. So our bottom is done. Let's flip this right side out so we can look at it. All right, there is our outer part of our bag. Isn't that cute? I love that gray. It's so pretty with the red. All right, so now we can set this aside and work on our interior panels. I got way too much SF-101 on the back of this, so I just need to trim that down. All right. So now I have these two pieces that we are going to make our slip pocket. So I'm going to put these together so we can sew them and then put them on our panel. Okay, so I'm going to go sew this from here all the way around to here so that we'll leave this open so we can turn it right side out. All right, so I've got that sewn. If you want to, you can cut your corners down. So we can just reduce a little bit of bulk. And then we'll start turning this the right way. I find that it's helpful if you run your little tool along your seam line here. It kind of helps that pop out and keep a straight line. Okay, so I'm gonna go and run my iron across here and see how this is kind of curved. If I can just get my tool in there and just run it along that line. So that it kind of, it makes it straighter. Okay, so I'm gonna go run my iron over this, and then I'm going to do a top stitch right across the top here. And then we will put it on our panel. Okay, so I ran our stitch across the top here. And so now I am going to pull both the threads to the back so that we can tie them off. So just like that, there are no loose threads or cut threads on the front. So now what we're going to do is figure out where to put this. That goes to the back or the sides, and that goes to the sides. I just want to make sure it's even, and it is not. Right, so what I'm going to do is just put a couple of pins in the middle to keep it in place. And then I'm going to sew all the way around here, and then we'll have our pocket. All right, so now we have our slip pocket on. It's sewn around the three sides. So now we can move on to our zipper pocket. Looks better. All right, so we are going to take our panel here. Mark off our sides. We're going to take one of these. Inch. I love this little ruler, but it is clear and it is hard to find sometimes. All right. I'm going to go down another half inch. Go a half inch in and draw my line. Go to this half inch. Then we're going to move down another half inch, draw our line. I'm going to take this and go a quarter inch. draw another line. And I'm going to make a little mark at the half inch. And draw up our little triangles. So I'm going to again just put some pins in down here to keep it in place. All right, so now we're going to go sew around this outside box and we'll be right back. All right, so that is sewn on there. So we're going to take our seam ripper. And we are going to make a little slit on the middle line so we can get our scissors in here. Do not cut through your stitches. Okay, so now we are going to pull all of this to the back as best as you can. I find that it's easier when you take it to the ironing board and pull all of this out really good and then iron it down as best as you can. So I'm going to do that and then we will come back and fit our little zipper in there. All right, so I've got that done. I'll put my zipper under there. And we're just going to try to pin this down to hold it in place. I know a lot of people use double-sided tape. My machine hates double-sided tape. I will have to change a needle every other stitch, so I do not use double-sided tape. Ooh, I got a fly in here. You're driving me nuts. that's how I do it. I try to just pin around the zipper to try to get it to where I want it to, so that it'll hold still until I can go and put a stitch around it and hold it in place. So I'm going to do that, and then we'll be right back. Okay, so our zipper panel is done. So now we're going to put these two together and line them up and do the magnetic snap. That's what my mom wants. Right now I'm trying to find the middle, so I'm marking off every 2 inches until we get to the middle. Clear. To get like a bright yellow little ruler. So I want to put the snap far enough down that when I attach the interior with the exterior, that the snap is not in the way. So maybe right there. Alright, so we are going to go through both sides. I'm going to stick that side through, pick it up. And put this side through. Give them a little extra padding. And then I like to put a little duct tape just to cover these prongs up, make sure they don't come out or make a hole in anything. And make sure you don't put the duct tape up in your stitch line. So you don't want to have to try to stitch through that. All right. Our snap is on. Now for the bottom. Line up my sides and go ahead and clip them. Okay, I'm going to go stitch down the bottom and the sides, and then we'll come back and do the corners. Okay, so we have the inside done. We have our slip pocket and our zipper pocket. Everything is done. So now what we are going to do is take the outside, and we're going to put it inside of this. Fold those down. So I'm going to start at the seams. Okay, so now I'm going to take this to the machine and I'm going to sew these together and we'll be right back. Okay, so we've got this sewn all the way around the top. So now it is time to pull everything through. Do not try to pull too much at once because you'll rip your zipper and that will not be good. And there it is. There is our bag. I do not have an industrial machine, and my domestic machine has a really hard time doing a top stitch around the top. So there is that. We need to make the straps. And then this bag is done. Let's see. What is this? 3 inches. I'm going to cut one more 3-inch strip to make our handle. Thank you. So these I got from Hobby Lobby. They are 1 inch. Okay, so what I'm doing here is if you take this, this is 3 inches. And we're going to fold each side over to that half inch mark. Then when we pull it together, it should be 1 inch. Okay. So let's do that all the way down. Okay, so here's one strap. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take it to the machine and we're gonna sew all the way across this double side right here and then back up this way, and it'll look really nice. So I'm going to fold the other one and then sew these, and we'll come back and put them on the bag. Okay, so here is our straps. I pulled everything to the back and I tied a knot so that it will not come unraveled. So what we're gonna do is we are going to put one of these swivel hooks on each side. We're gonna fold it over about an inch and a quarter and clip it. So make sure that it's not twisted. To this side. So those are good. I'm actually going to try to go put a stitch across here on each one of these, and then we will put it on the bag. All right. So we have, I did just stitch a little across here to give them some added security. And then I'm going to put a rivet on each one right here, just right below that. So I get these double-sided cap rivets, double cap rivets from Hobby Lobby. I'm gonna poke my hole. Cap on it. And I have this little tool here. Just smash it together. this strap. There you go. There's my mom's Christmas bag. So I'm going to clean this mess up and then we will make her a matching wallet. All right. So here is my mom's Christmas bag and her wallet. I did gray leather all the way around the outside. And then the inside has the other two colors that match the bag. I hope she likes it. Y'all have a great day. Thank you.